We aren't going to use that particular Barry White robot quite yet. I've had the good fortune of pursuing a couple of careers in my life so far. When I went to undergrad, I started out pre-med and then encountered organic chemistry and then took a turn away. And I was going to school in Silicon Valley, so the school that I went to had a seductively fun computer science, intro to computer science series. And it lulled many of us innocent victims into thinking that we could code. And so I took some introductory courses. I'm like, this is fun. I'll major in this. And then of course, I encountered operating systems and compilers and machine learning and things like that. And then things were more challenging, and I think a lot more fun for some people whose brains are wired in that way. And for me, it was this big struggle, but it was a beautiful struggle to go through. And so I majored in computer science and then graduated and went to work in a cubicle writing code. And that was a really formative time of my life because it actually really made me realize how much I wanted to do music. Which is really no disrespect to the software engineering profession, because it was a great gig to have. But it was also the time of the dot-com bust, the first dot-com bust. And it was also around the time of Enron. It was around the time of Silicon Valley getting pretty weird, because there were a lot of people making fortunes of things that wasn't really clear what exactly their companies did or what they might be worth. But people were pouring their lives into it and sacrificing a lot of other pieces of their lives. And I think in the wake of that bust, a lot of people sort of woke up to the realization of, wait, I didn't want to do that. I didn't want to sign the rest of my life for this. And in the midst of all that, I also watched the movie Office Space. So you just take all of those things, put them into a songwriter's brain, and eventually a song comes out called Whatever You Want.
Thank you.
question you all night. No one would dare to stand up. In the night she leaves the papers in a tidy pile, evidence for her reasons. And in the night he takes the main accounts and pulls the files, detailing every treason. I am the last one you'd ever suspect of setting the